So, remember ESR that we talked about is the erythrocyte sedimentation rate. That means the rate at which RBCs will settle. The rate at which RBC will settle. So normally, when the RBCs are remain suspended uniformly in the circulation, called as suspension stability of the RBC. Now, when the blood is mixed with an anticoagulant, what happens is, when you allow to stand it in a vertical tube, that vertical tube, we have two types of tube that we should know, Western Grains tube that we know, and Western Pintrope tube. The RBCs will settle down because of the gravity. Because of the gravity, called the supernant layer of the clear fluid. Of course, as we know, when we do the PCV, we'll have to centrifuge it. But in ESR, they just allow the blood to stand in a tube. Let's say, for example, this is what is a tube, and this is what is blood. So they mix the blood with an anticoagulant and allow to stand. It is allowed to stand. So what happens is the RBCs will settle down. So after some time, what you see is, let me draw it again. After some time, the RBCs will settle down and you will have a clear plasma above. So this rate at which the RBCs settle down is about 8 to 10 millimeters per hour, the first hour rather. And that is what is an ESR. So we take the two tubes, in Western Grains tube and Wintrob's tube. It is about Wintrob's tube and Western Grains tube. That is what is taken in this particular situation. Now we have certain situations in which ESR is more. We have so many things. Now remember, this is what is an important slide again. I'll take the screenshots later on, that factors affecting the ESR. So if you see in the complete blood count, ESR is high. You can interpret it like factors. We also have specific gravity of the RBCs, Rolux formation that we know is a formation of a coagulum. Size of the RBC, viscosity of the blood, RBC count, all those will affect the ESR. If the specific gravity of RBC is more, let's interpret this. If this is more, they're going to settle faster. So ESR is also high. Rolux formation, again high. Size of the RBC is again high. If the viscosity of the blood is more, it is going to be reduced, because if the viscosity is more, they will not settle down properly. So variation, less ESR is found in the infants. Again, understand the reason behind that. As we know, infants has got hemoglobin more. The hemoglobin is high, viscosity is more, ESR is less in children. More in case of females, because hemoglobin is less. So RBCs will settle down faster. And also depending upon the pregnancy, from third month until parturition is increased. The reason behind that is again anemia because of pregnancy. Or a relative anemia, relative more plasma volume because of pregnancy. These are the physiological variations in case of an ESR. Whereas we also have the pathological interpretations in this particular situation. But remember, pathologically, ESR can be increased. I mean, there are so many causes. Remember, ESR is a non-specific investigation because it can be increased in so many situations. But it can give you a clue that something is going wrong. Remember, ESR is not a specific investigation. It is a non-specific investigation. So ESR is increased in case of all anemias that we talked about, except sickle cell. Remember, sickle cell mein RBCs are sickle shaped like this, and it is difficult for the sickle RBC to settle down because they are sickle shaped. They will float in the plasma more and more. They will rather float in the plasma. The reason behind that is this particular thing. Remember that. We also have tuberculosis increases, malignant tumor increases, rheumatoid arthritis, rheumatic fever, liver disorders, all that. Because of that, I did talk about this is a non-specific investigation. It is a non-specific investigation. And ESR can be reduced in sickle cell. Remember that sickle cell RBCs are like this. So if the RBCs are like this, they will not settle down that fast. Polycythemia we talked about, because the viscosity, in case of polycythemia, the viscosity is more. And when the viscosity is more, it is difficult for RBCs to settle down. More leukocytosis, and also we have shock like situations in which we have. The next one which we can interpret in the CBC is MCV, stands for mean corpuscular volume. Now remember, we usually will continue till 9:30 maximum, so be patient. Usually 1 hour is more than enough sometimes to for the online lecture, because it's difficult to concentrate. So let's say for them MCV, that we know is MCV, we discuss that is a mean corpuscular volume. It is the volume of one RBC. Of course, this is what is the formula. They take the 100 ml of blood and they take the count of an RBC and they divide it. So this is what is about volume of one RBC. It is about 80 to 90 micron cube. And we all also know that anemias are also classified depending upon the size of an RBC. Like for example, we have MCV less than 80 for microcytic anemias. Micro stands for small, cytic stands for cells, that we know. Normocytic, this is about MCV is normal. Macrocytic, we have anemias in which size of the RBC is more, that we know is megaloblastic anemias, folic acid deficiency anemias, B12 deficiency anemias, etc. In which RBC size is rather more. So MCV can interpret the type of anemia. And also remember, it is not only this, but we also understand the cause. For example, if you have a microcytic anemia, remember the most common cause here is iron deficiency. Microcytic I'm talking about. So in the CBC count, if the MCV is less than 80, 90% it can be possibility is iron deficiency. But not only this, it can also be a thalassemia. The third common cause is a protein deficiency anemia. So remember, we know about the causes of anemia depending upon the size of an RBC. Normocytic, a cell size is normal, it can be because of a recent blood loss or the initial stage of an iron deficiency anemia. Recent blood loss has got normocytic anemia. And macrocytic, that we already have understood, macrocytic anemia is because of B12 folic acid deficiencies. Or it can also be because of pernicious anemia that we know. That we are going to talk about later part of this particular presentation. So also understand about the cause looking at the MCH is an investigation. Take the screenshot right now. It may also have. Take the screenshot right now if it is possible. And then we can take things forward. Right. MCV. And we also have MCH. Let's understand the MCH is a mean corpuscular hemoglobin. That means it is an amount of hemoglobin in one RBC. As you know, it is 27 to 32 or 33 picogram per RBC. So anemias also have a normochromic. Now remember, what is a chroma? Chroma stands for color, that we know. The normochromic stands for color of the RBC is normal. This is again a recent blood loss. Can have normochromic anemia, or we can also have an hypochromic. That means RBCs look more pale because amount of hemoglobin in RBC is reduced. So hypochromic. Can also be hypochromic. Hypo stands for less, chroma stands for color again. So pale RBCs. RBCs are looking more pale. So if you combine these two together, we can have types of anemia. Like for example, we have microcytic, hypochromic. Microcytic, normochromic. We also have normocytic, normochromic. And we also have a macrocytic, hypochromic. So when you combine these two indices, we have different types of anemia. That was in the physiology, of course. You can just go through this to understand. So that was an MCH. And this is how we can calculate that. And MCHC finally is the ratio of volume to amount of an RBCs into 100. So, or I can say percentage is how we can calculate them, the mathematics one. But volume is 90, amount is 30, so it becomes 33%. It becomes 33%. That is what then? It becomes 33%, right? Okay. It becomes a 33%. So this is what it's about, approximately 30 to 38%. 30 to 38%, right? Now let's call it a day for some, because this is what is a little complicated one. I hope, let me unmute you for some time if you have anything that can be. Just a minute. We're going to have a next lecture on 17th, same time. And remember, the link to the lecture is going to remain the same. So you can just click on the link and open through Zoom app. That's it. Link also you can share with your friends, because these are the things I have kept it for free. So you can also share with your friends and let all get connected. And also ask them to download and install Zoom. And then they also can join. Of course, the only condition is you have to remain in a quiet place. But because if it is a disturbance coming up, I'm going to mute all of you. Usually in a professional lectures, everyone takes it seriously. So even in a quiet place, we can have a live discussion going on. So, but if the disturbance is coming up, then you can mute all of you. That is what you can do. Right. Okay. I think somebody has a doubt. Okay, fine. Okay. So let's get connected on 17th again for the second session, then we can plan for third and fourth session to complete this particular series. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.